Hello student, welcome to online tutorial session. Today we will learn about the next part of the chapter. So the first topic for today is the hexadecimal to octal conversion and octal to hexadecimal conversions. Okay, so you are able to see this formula. It is there 9A8C. Whenever there is A, B, C, D, this kind of a value is include, you have to understand it is in base 16. So base 16 to base 8. First of all, you just go through this list first. This is very important one. In the previous class also, I have demonstrated that binary representation, decimal to binary representation, hexadecimal and octadecimal. So actually decimal value, if you want to represent in hexadecimal, there is a 4-bit representation. Okay, so how will you get that? 8421 is the shortcut method. Okay, in the online session I will discuss about the shortcuts method, how to remember this representation. Okay, so you have to remember this table: hexadecimal representation, 4-bit representation, equivalent of octal representation. Okay, so first question is coming, that is 9A8C we will convert into particular base 8. So how we can convert? First we will write down the hexadecimal equivalent. Okay, now we will convert to 16 to base 2. So we will write down C means what? Here you can, if you check, C means 12. Okay, check here, C means what? 12. 12 means 1100. So here, that's why here C means 1100. It is written C means 1100. Next 8 means 100. A means 1010. 9 means 1001. Okay, 1001 is there. And right now we have to convert it into the octal number system. So octal number conversion rule is that from right hand side to left hand side we will club 3. So after writing 16 to base 2, we have converted. Now we are clubbing 3 digit each. 001, next 100, next one is 010, next one 101, 100, and now only one is there. So you have to make this work, this bit work. So that's why it is one bit is there, and you have to put 2 bit extra to make it a 3-bit. So that's why you just replace this bit with zeros. Okay, now we have to convert. Now 100 in octal representation means 4, 001 represent 1, 010 represent 2, 101 represent 5, 001 represent 1, and 001 represent 1. So in this way, if you want to convert from hexadecimal to octal, so first we have to do hexadecimal to binary, then from the binary we will convert into octal number system. Okay, now we are coming to the second one, that is 60D. Okay, so D is what? D is 13. So 13 means 1101. So D means 13 means 1101, and 0 is 4 times represent, 4 bit represent is 4 times 0, and 6 is 0110. Okay, 6, and now we have converted into binary. Now we will convert. Now we will from right hand side to left hand side we will club 3 digit. So 101 we have converted, now 100, now 000, now it is 110. So 101 means 5. Okay, 001 means 1, 000 means 0, and 011 means is 3. So 6D in 16, if you convert it into hexadecimal, it becomes 3015. So first hexadecimal to binary, then binary to octal. Okay, in this way we are actually doing this. Now we are moving to the hexadecimal to octal one. Okay, octal to hexadecimal to octal we have done. So now we will convert octal to hexadecimal. Okay, so So first question it is there 4057 and 8 base 8 is there and 16. So again we have to repeat the same thing, that from octal base 2 we have to convert into the binary, that is base 2, and then from base 2 to we will convert to base 16. So 7 in binary means 111. See, it is written 111. 5 it means 101. See, it is written 101. Okay, 0 means 3 times 0 and 4 means 100. So that is we have written. And now if you convert it into hexadecimal is 4 bit representation, right? So from right hand side to left hand side we will club 4 digit H. So now we are clubbing 1111. Okay, and now 0100 and now 0010. So here there is no shortage of bit, so that's why it is done beautifully. We can club 4 digit H. But may it happens that sometimes also there is a shortage of a bit, then that bit, the shortage number of bit we will replace by 0. So the next example we will able to see that. So 11111 in hexadecimal means it is 15. 1111 means 15. So 15 means F. Okay, now 0010 it is represents 2 and 1000 represents 8. So from 4057 base 8 to, if you want to convert it in 16, the result is 82F. Okay, now coming to the next example, that is 6158 to base 16. Okay, so one time check, that is 5 means what? 101. 6 means what? 110. Okay, sorry, 1 is there, so 001 and 6 means 110. Okay, so we have converted and tried to add four digits. So 1011 done. 0001 done. Only single one is there, and next 3 bit is blank. It's blank piece. There is a shortage of bit. So this particular shortage of bits we must replace with this 3 zeros. Okay. So if you combine, then what will happen? 1101 means D. It's 30, and 1000 means 8, and 0001 means 1. Okay. So in this way, we are actually convert the octal to hexadecimal conversion. Okay, so if whether it a hexadecimal to octal, hexadecimal to binary, first we come, then from binary to hexadecimal. If it is octal to hexadecimal, then from octal you have to first come to the binary, and then from the binary you have to convert it to the hexadecimal one. Okay, there is a few in the previous two video you will see the Google Drive link is there. From the Google Drive link there is a homework PDF will be there, so you have to go through this homework PDF. Okay, there is a homework is there, you have to convert one, you have to copy, solve it, and then submit your copy. Okay, now today I am ending my lecture over here, and the next day I will start with the decimal fraction to binary fraction. This is the next day topic. Today I will not start, but with this video I am attaching another PDF, homework PDF number 3. Please go through and solve and submit the copy. Thank you, stream. I am ending my lecture.